Good morning, students. My name is Mandeep Kaur from California Public School. Hope that all of you are fine, and I also hope that you are doing all the questions at your home. Now let's start today's topic. Before starting today's topic, I just want to tell you what we have already finished. Yesterday we have finished a question regarding the equality of a complex number, and secondly we have discussed about the conjugate of a complex number. Now today we will discuss about the multiplicative inverse of complex number. How to find the multiplicative inverse of complex numbers. Complex number. Along with this, we will also discuss about a few unsolved questions of the worksheet complex number. Now let's start from the multiplicative inverse of complex number. Let us take some example that you can understand it easily, in which we can find the multiplicative inverse of a complex number. Let us suppose we have a complex number z is equal to 2 minus 3 iota. Z is equal to 2 minus 3 iota, and we have to find its multiplicative inverse. Now look at here, inverse is there. That means we have to find its inverse. Now, in which way we can find its inverse? Its inverse means that you have to find 1 over z. We have to find its multiplicative inverse. That means z inverse we have to find, and that is we have to find 1 over z. Now, put the value here. Here is 1 over the value of z is 2 minus 3 iota. 2 minus 3 iota. Now look at here, whenever we have a complex number in the form of denominator, you just have to do its rationalizing. So do its rationalizing. Here is negative symbol, so you have to do its rationalizing by 2 plus 3 iota, 2 plus 3 iota. After that, you have to do its multiplication, 1 into 2 plus 3 iota, that is 2 plus 3 iota. And in the denominator, look at here, here is a minus b into a plus b. So we can use our identity here, that is a square minus of b square. The value of a is 2 and the value of b is 3 iota. So use our identity, that is a square minus of b square. After this we have, here is 2 plus 3 iota. And in the denominator, now here is 2 square, that is 4. Here is negative. Now here is 3 square is 9. Along with this iota square. 3 square is 9 and here is iota square. After this we have 2 plus 3 iota over. Now here is 4. Now everyone knows that what is the value of iota square? That is minus 1. So it becomes minus minus plus 9. So it becomes minus minus plus 9. So we have 2 plus 3 iota and 9 plus 4, that is 13. Now look at here. We have to convert it in a form of a complex number. So you just have to write in this way, 2 by 13 plus 3 by 13 iota. That is our complex number. The real part is 2 by 13 and its imaginary part is 3 by 13. That is a multiplicative inverse of a complex number. Let us take one more example that you can understand it easily, in which way we have find the multiplicative inverse of a complex number. Okay, now one more question regarding this. Z is equal to root 5 plus 3 iota. Root 5 plus 3 iota. Again, we have to find its multiplicative inverse. We have to find its inverse. That means Z inverse. That means 1 over Z. Put the value. Here is Z is root 5 plus 3 iota. Root 5 plus 3 iota. Now, again, we have to do its rationalizing. By root 5, here is positive, so make it negative over root 5 minus 3 iota. After this, we have 1 into this, that is root 5 minus 3 iota, and in the denominator, again a plus b into a minus b, that is a square minus of b square. So the value of a is root 5, that means root 5 square, and the value of b is 3 iota, that means 3 iota square. After this, we have root 5 minus of 3 iota, and here is root 5 square, that is only 5. Root 5 square is only 5 because square root and square both are cancelled. And in this side we have 3 square is 9, and here is iota square. Now we have root 5 minus of 3 iota divided by, again we have the value of iota square is minus 1. So minus minus becomes plus 9. So 5 plus 9 is there. Here is 5 plus 9. So it becomes root 5 minus 3 iota, and 9 plus 5, that is 14. After this we have root 5 over 14 minus 3 over 14 iota, which is our multiplicative inverse. So its real part is root 5 over 14 and its imaginary part is minus 3 over 14. Now come to the next question of this worksheet. Okay, now come to the next question of this worksheet. We have to find the conjugate of, we have to find its conjugate. 3 minus 2 iota into 2 plus 3 iota divided by 1 plus 2 iota into 2 minus iota. Now keep it in your mind, whenever we have to find the conjugate, whenever we have to find the multiplicative inverse, and whenever we have to find the modulus, firstly we have to convert all these in a form of a complex number. So firstly you have to convert it in the form of a complex number. So do its multiplication. 3 into 2 plus 3 iota. 3 into 2 plus 3 iota, that is 3 2s are 6. Here is 3 3s are 9 iota. After this minus 2 iota into 2, that is minus of 4 iota. And here is minus 2 iota into 3 iota, that is plus minus minus 3 2s are 6 iota square. Similarly, in the denominator, 1 into 2 minus iota, that is 2 minus iota, and here is 2 iota into 2, that is 2 2s are 4 iota, and here is 2 iota minus iota, that is minus of 2 iota square. After this we have 6, here is 9 minus 9 iota minus 4 iota, that is positive 5 iota, and here put the value of iota square, that is minus of 1, so it becomes minus minus plus 6 is there. Same in the denominator we have, here is 2, here is minus iota plus 4 iota, so it becomes 3 iota, and here is the value of iota square is again minus 1, so it becomes minus minus plus 2. So it becomes 6 plus 6, that is 12 plus 5 iota divided by 2 plus 2, that is 4 plus 3 iota. 4 plus 3 iota. Now again look at here, that is also not in form of a complex number. So what we have to do, if we have in a fractional form, you have to do its rationalizing. Firstly, we have to convert it into a form of a complex number. After that, we have to find its conjugate. So we have to do its rationalizing to convert it into a form of a complex number. Here is 12 plus 5 iota over 4 plus 3 iota. Now we have to do its rationalizing. Here is 4 plus 3 iota. So 4 minus 3 iota over 4 minus 3 iota. After this, do its multiplication, numerator by its numerator, denominator by its denominator. So 12 into 4, that is 48. 12 into 3, that is 36 iota. After this, 5 iota into 4, that is 5 4s are 20 iota. And 5 iota into minus 3 iota, that is 5 3s are 15 iota square. Now in the denominator, look at here. Here is a plus b, here is a minus b. So we can use our entry, that is a square minus of b square. The value of a is 4 and the value of b is 3 iota. Now after this we have, here is 48. Now minus 36 plus 20, that becomes minus of 16 iota. And again iota square, the value of iota square is minus 1. So minus minus, here is plus 15. And here is 4 square 16. And here is 3 square 9. And again iota square. Iota square is minus 1. So it becomes minus minus plus. After is 48 plus 15. That becomes 63 minus of 16 iota. And here is 25. So it can be written as 63 over 25 minus 16 over 25 iota. That is a complex number. Look at here. Its real part is 63 over 25. And its imaginary part is minus 16 over 25. So firstly you have to convert it in the form of a complex number. Now what we have to find? We have to find its conjugate. And in which way we can find its conjugate? You just have to change its center symbol. So Here is the value 63 over 25 and minus 16 over 25 either. We have to find its conjugate, and its conjugate is 63 over 25. Just change its center symbol negative to positive. If here is positive, make it negative 16 over 25 iota, which is our required answer. Now come to the next portion of this worksheet. Okay, now come to the next question of this worksheet. We have to find the modulus of 1 plus iota over 1 minus iota. Here is negative 1 minus iota over 1 plus iota. So again, I'm going to repeat this. Whenever we have to find conjugate, whenever we have to find modulus, whenever we have to find multiplicative, firstly, you have to convert it into form of a complex number. So you have to convert it into form of a complex number. Firstly, we have to take its LCM. Its LCM is 1 minus iota into 1 plus iota. LCM is 1 minus iota into 1 plus iota. Here is 1 plus iota whole square. And in this side, we have 1 minus iota whole square. Now, here we can use the identity a plus b whole square. And here we can use the identity a minus b whole square. So, use the identity a square, that is 1 square 1, plus b square, that is iota square, plus 2ab, that is 2 iota. And in this side, we have negative. So, here is bracket, 1 square is 1 plus b square, that is iota square, minus 2ab, that is minus of 2 iota. And in the denominator, again, we have a minus b into a plus b, that is a square minus of b square. The value of a is 1, that means 1 square, and the value of b is iota, that means iota square. After this, we have again put the value of iota square. The value of iota square is minus of 1. Here is 2 iota and here is 1. Again, the value of iota square is minus 1 and here is minus of 2 iota. And in the denominator, 1 square is 1. The value of iota square is minus 1. So, minus minus plus 1 is there. So, here is negative and positive. Both are cancelled. So, 2 iota is there. Here is 2 iota. And here is again positive negative. Both are cancelled. So, minus minus, that is plus 2 iota. Here is plus 2 iota and in the denominator we have 1 plus 1, that is 2. So divide it, 2 iota by 2, that is only iota. Sorry, we have 2 iota plus 2 iota. Here is 2 iota plus 2 iota, that is 4 iota over 2 is there. Here is 2 iota minus minus plus, that is 2 iota. So we have 2 iota plus 2 iota, that is 4 iota divided by 2. Now 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. So, we have 2 iota is there. That is not a complex number because only imaginary part is there. So, firstly convert it into form of a complex number. So, you can write it in this way, 0 plus 2 iota. Now, what we have to find? We have to find its modulus. We have to find its modulus. Let us suppose that is equal to z. Let us suppose that is equal to z, 0 plus 2 iota, and we have to find its modulus. So, its modulus is equal to its real part square plus its imaginary part square. So, 0 square plus 2 square. So, its modulus is, here 0 square is 0 and 2 square is 4. So, the square root of 4 is 2. So, its modulus is 2. Now, come to the next portion of this worksheet. Okay, now come to the next question of this worksheet. We have z is equal to 3 minus root 7 iota and we have to find z inverse. After that, its modulus. Now, look at here. Firstly, we have to find its inverse. After that, we have to find its modulus. So, we have z is equal to 3 minus root 7 iota. So, its inverse is 1 over 3 minus root 7 iota is there. Now, what we have to do? We have to do its rationalizing. So, here is 3 plus root 7 iota is there and here is 3 plus root 7 iota. Now, 1 into this, that is 3 plus root 7 iota and here is again a minus b, a plus b, that is a square minus of b square. After this, we have 3 plus root 7 iota over 3 square is 9. Root 7 square is 7. Iota square is minus 1, so it becomes minus minus plus. Root 7 square, that is only 7. Here is iota square. The value of iota square is minus 1. So, it becomes minus minus plus. So, we have 3 plus root 7 iota over 9 plus 7. That is 16 is there. So, we can write it in this way. Here is 3 by 16 and root 7 over 16 iota is there. That is our complex number. Now, what we have to find its modulus. We have to find its modulus. And everyone knows that in which way we can find its modulus. So, you have to find its modulus yourself. And I hope that all of you have been clear about in which way I have solved all these questions. And now for tomorrow, we will discuss some tricky questions of a complex number that you can understand really easily, in which way we can find the imaginary of Z1, Z2 over Z1 conjugate, something, these types of questions we will discuss tomorrow. Thank you so much, everyone.